Once the opportunity arose for him to close the show, he did it in emphatic style.
Whatever he hits falls.
Andrew McCart, IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm here in New York. With me, a very, very lovely Heather Hardy. Heather, very passionate speech with Lou DeBella about, you've been passionate about it yourself, the equality and pay for women's boxing. Before we talk about the fight itself, are you happy with the pay that you're getting?
Well, it's a career high payday for me, for both boxing and MMA, so that's nice. But to say that, I have to say me and Amanda are selling out this show, and without it seeming like, you know, all Heather does is complain about the pay, men would be making in the millions for this fight, and we're not even making six figures.
Well, you said it yourself, but you mentioned that the fight with Amanda's selling this whole card. Could this fight, could you have headlined?
Oh, we could have headlined for sure. We're the ones responsible for all the ticket sales, right? I mean, of course we could have headlined.
When do you think, how long before we do see a female fighter headlining a card? Maybe a whole female fight card?
I think that, see, the problem is you still have boxing promoters investing most of their money in men. So where you have Devin Haney here, Eddie Hearn invests a lot of money in him, right? He needs to promote him, he needs to showcase him so that he can make more money off him. Eddie Hearn stands to make more money off of Devin Haney than he does off of me and Amanda. And until women get to a spot where we're producing enough money for promoters, and they're not really going to be invested in caring where we are in the card. Like Amanda and I, our own resume got us to this co-main event status, knowing that, yeah, they'll pull their own way. They'll sell their tickets, they'll get the media buzz, people will talk about it. But until promoters start actually generating money off of women, we're always going to be...
We'll get there.
We will. I'm 37 though, so I'm not going to be there for
you're
it.
You're a young 37.
Yeah.
I'm 37 as well, but I'm way older than you. That's neither here nor there, but I want to talk about the fight itself then. Amanda Serrano, I mean, you've said it yourself, it's probably your toughest fight to date. I mean, she chose you because you were the WBO champion. What kind of fight are you expecting to win between you and Amanda?
Well, I know she's expecting to win. I know that she's expecting a hard fight because she knows I'm relentless, she knows I'm tough, she knows I got a good chin, but she's definitely expecting to win, as her team is expecting to win. So I got to go out there and let them know.
Also, I don't know if this was true or not, but it might have just been a thing Lou DeBella said at the press conference, the Queen of Brooklyn title. Is that an actual thing? Is that happening?
The Garden put up a title for the Queen of Brooklyn.
It's an actual belt?
It's an actual belt, I suppose. I was hearing for it for the first time today, so I don't know.
Okay, what does that mean to you? Would that mean anything?
Honestly, it means nothing. Titles mean nothing to me. I wish that they did, but they don't. Like, when I got my world title, Gleason's gym has a history of they hang and they immortalize you when you win a world title. So I got my banner at Gleason's gym. It'll hang there forever. I did my job.
You did your job.
I don't need, right now, this is more like my pride. I'm a Brooklyn girl. You called me out. You want to fight me. Like my mom taught me when I was young, like somebody push you, you push them back. Somebody hit you, you hit them back. Somebody tells you they want to fight, we fight.
I noticed that you put the clover sometimes after your thing. You got Irish in?
Yep, I'm third generation, second generation
American.
Can I
just show you that tattoo then?
Oh, I can't lift up my dress, but...
You've got a clover in there somewhere? Oh, there it is, yep.
A whole bunch of them. I got them all over. My grandma's from Dublin.
Dublin?
Yeah, they cross back and forth because my grandfather was born in Dublin, my grandmother's from Scotland. So they travel back and forth.
Well, I'm Scottish.
Oh, is that right?
So, I think that's what you get in your fighting from, being a Celtic, all that Celtic blood in you.
For sure.
I mean, what does winning this fight do for your career? I mean, are you looking to push on to maybe unify the division after this?
Well, the winner of this fight has to fight Katie Taylor within the next 6 months, which is a six-figure payday. So that's my incentive. I'm a single mom. I have a kid going to college in 2 years. I need to pay that tuition. Outside of that, I would like to unify my division at 126. The WBC title world championship has always been a dream of mine since the very beginning. Alicia Ashley was one of my first coaches, and she held the super bantamweight, and I used to walk in her office and see it on the wall. I'm just saying, I want one of those. And my 122 days are long gone, so I have my sights on the featherweight, WBC.
You mentioned Katie Taylor. It'd be remiss of me not to talk about her then. I mean, you mentioned you're a single mother, you've got to put your kid through college and all that sort of stuff. Fighting Katie Taylor, is that a headline show? Is that like the biggest, that will be the biggest payday you've faced?
It'll be my biggest payday. But the thing is like, I'm so used to being the one to set the table, right? I'm the name, everyone knows me, they come and sit at my table, I feed them. Katie is the one, this is her table. I'm not her biggest
fan. Do you mind eating at somebody else's table?
If there's good food there, I'm going.
Well, then I'm sure
Katie's got a nicer table than I got, so.
Well, there you go, you said it. I think that's
I'm coming, baby. Yeah, I don't care.
I was going to say, that's you accepting the fight, then if you win, I'm fighting.
For sure, that's what it is. I mean, it's a six-figure payday. Boxing is a business. Look, Amanda is the scarier fighter, right? Amanda's the one who's knocking people unconscious 27 out of whatever times. I'm not scared of nobody. My mama taught me that. Like,
well, Amanda's lost. You haven't in boxing. Yeah. So there is that. So.
Yeah, well, Amanda really didn't lose that fight.
Yeah.
But there's the politics of boxing
for you.
So, and I'm up against the politics of boxing in this one because I'm not the favorite. I'm not the one with the mantrum, so.
Do you have to knock Amanda out?
No, I don't think so.
No?
I just gotta put on a good show.
Definitely.
I gotta put on a good show. Well, I gotta make it look easy.
Well, good luck to you on that because I can say Amanda's a very good fighter as well.
Thank you.
I know you've got a busy media day ahead of you, but one last question. What can the fans at Madison Square Garden and watching on the Zone expect from you on the Friday night?
I'm going to shock the world on Friday night. It's going to be a full moon Friday the 13th.
And I can't wait. Yeah. I'm going to be a fan for that fight. So again, it's probably going to be steal the show. My personal opinion is the fight I'm looking forward to. That's why I've traveled 3,000 miles to come and watch these girls fight. So I hope you put on a show and I'm glad you did. But thanks
for
doing
this, Michael.
Nice meeting you, Heather. Thank you very much.
Opportunity arose for him to close the show, and he did it in emphatic style.
Whatever he hits, falls.